Chris, in your in the mission of your church, you talk about building new forms of church with young people. And so anytime I think about new, I'm also thinking about innovation. And so I want to know, what type of innovations should we be thinking about when we think about youth ministry and working with adolescents?
I mean, that's a really great question. And the particularities of that, like what it looks like for us in Reading and versus what it might look like in New Haven, are going to be, there's going to be some similarities and there's going to be great differences as well. We know there's some particular challenges at the moment. We've talked about kind of mental health issues. We've talked about identity. It's going to be a massive thing. Belonging is going to be a thing. What it means to live as a responsible Christian in a world which knows so much about what's happening in other parts of the world. What's our responsibility to our neighbours that we've never met, but we know what's happening in their lives? What about power? What about money? What about weapons of war? All these things are really pressing things. But I think in it, I want to, I suppose, take a step back and say, right, rather than me just tell young people what I think the things are that they need to do, what's the Spirit saying and doing, and how do I need to enable and shape these young lives in order that they might be able to answer those questions themselves? I remember hearing a great thing someone once saying. He said, I realized what I was doing with my teenagers is I realized I was telling them all the things that I'd learned as a teenager, and trying to help them learn all the lessons that I should have learned as a teenager, and so they didn't make the mistakes that I made as a teenager, and that they should take up all the things that I took up as a teenager. And he said, what I realized I was doing is I was doing the same thing that Saul did to David before Goliath. I was just dressing them in my own armor. And we do that the whole time in the church. There's this huge thing, the horizon's dominated by this big Goliath. And so if we think equipping our young people simply means giving them everything that we've just had to this battle, we don't need to do that. And that's not trusting the Spirit either. We need to say, we'll do all we can to shape you young people to be able to do this that God's calling you to do. And we will absolutely trust the Spirit, that the Spirit is faithful and God will give you everything you need in discerning this and in living this life for Christ in ways that we could never imagine. And our job is to enable you to be able to do that and to hear and to receive and then to step forward into it.